This is Clear Your Head, the simple guide to enjoying your life without anxiety getting in the way. Narrated by Tim Box, created by HypnoArts Publications.
This book was originally created as a live interview. That's why it reads as a conversation rather than a traditional book that talks at you. It's also why it isn't after an award for literature, but it will engage, educate, and empower you. I wanted you to feel as though I'm talking with you, much like a close friend or relative. I felt that creating the material this way would make it easier for you to grasp the topics and put them to use quickly, rather than wading through hundreds of heavily edited pages. So relax and get ready to know how to enjoy your life without anxiety getting in the way, so you can understand that anxiety can be your friend, not your enemy. Let's get started and clear your head right now.
Introduction. Hi everyone, and welcome to Clear Your Head, especially for anxiety sufferers. As with all of HypnoArts experts' works, if you want to enhance your experience of life, then there will be advice and techniques you should know and will benefit from whether you're an anxiety sufferer or not. My name is John Chase, and today I'm talking with anxiety control expert Tim Box about what all anxiety sufferers need to have to be successful with anxiety control and get the best results. Introducing Tim Box. Tim Box is a hands-on expert on the subject of anxiety control and has graciously consented to this interview to share with us the advice, techniques, and strategies every anxiety sufferer can and must develop in order to know how to enjoy your life without anxiety getting in the way. Tim's had a grammar school education. He studied English literature and philosophy at Kent University. He's a registered advanced hypnotist, holds a hypnotherapy practitioner diploma and a diploma in clinical advanced hypnotherapy. He's had 7 years running a full-time remedial hypnosis practice and runs one-day control workshops for anxiety sufferers around the country. Tim is also a fellow of the Academy of Hypnotic Arts and a member of the National Council for Hypnotherapy. He's spoken and trained at BNI, that's Business Network International, at their national conference, and he won Complementary Health Practitioner of the Year at the Kent Health and Beauty Awards, both of those in 2016. In 2015, he developed his control system, making changes in patterns of thought. If you're an anxiety sufferer, most of what you need is instruction and encouragement from someone who's been there and done that, with how to enjoy your life without anxiety getting in your way. As you can see, anxiety control expert Tim Box is uniquely qualified to help you understand everything you need to know about getting control of anxiety without drugs in the vast majority of cases. Welcome, Tim.
Hello, John.
What is Clear Your Head? Let's jump right in with a quick summary explanation. Tim, in a short sentence or two, what is Clear Your Head?
Clear Your Head is a way of thinking or understanding how the mind works. It shows you how to enjoy your life without anxiety getting in the way. When you understand how this works and you understand how your mind's working, you'll be able to sleep well, increase your self-esteem and your confidence levels and basically clear your head.
Tim's story. Tim, tell us, how did you get here?
Originally, back when I left university having studied philosophy, I left to join a band and I was a bit of a punk rocker for a bit. During that time, I had to do something to pay the bills, so I became a plumber. The reason I bring this into my story is because one of the side effects of doing plumbing was that I learned to have a general good level of rapport with people. When I went into plumbing, I had a fair amount of social anxiety. Even though I'd be on stage playing to sometimes thousands of people, if I was lucky, sometimes two people and a dog. But no matter how many people there were, I had that wall of sound behind me that was protecting me. When it came to actually engaging in one-on-one conversations, I was not good at it, and I would shy away from it at every opportunity. What becoming a plumber did was had me go into people's houses, talking to them, having to gain their trust. Around that time, everything on the TV was about rogue traders and how all the tradesmen were going to rip you off. All I was doing, I was just in my dad's company. I was helping him out, and he was spending the last 10 years of his working life back on the tools. Then it came that time when he said, "Okay, I'm going to retire now. How about I give you the plumbing company?" And I thought, "Whoa, hang on a minute. Am I going to be a plumber the rest of my life?" Coming from an academic and an artistic and creative background, that wasn't what I wanted to be. And just to clarify, I was a very specific type of plumber. I was a shit plumber. It wasn't my calling at all. Basically, I needed to find something else. It was around this time that I started to get more and more into the mind and how it worked. Around that time, YouTube was just coming into my awareness, and I was starting to watch videos and do my education about this stuff online. You know when you go to YouTube and you look at a video and then it shows you down the side of the screen 8 other videos that might interest you, and then 2 that are completely unrelated to that video in any way. Before you know it, you're looking at cats falling off sofas and you're learning how to solve a Rubik's Cube and stuff like that when you never had any interest in it before. Then I saw down at the bottom of the screen when I was looking at a video, a hypnosis video. Just a video of somebody hypnotizing somebody. I clicked on that because I had a vague interest in it before. I started to follow this video paper trail through the world of hypnosis. Then I chanced upon, funnily enough, one of your videos, John. John Chase talking about frequently asked questions in hypnosis. As you'll know very well, and anyone that's studied any hypnosis or even dipped their toe into it will know, there are as many different definitions of hypnosis as there are hypnotists. You get a different story about what it is from everyone. I watched your video and I remember thinking, I really hope that's what it is. Because if it is, I want to do that. I'd be interested in that. I went onto your website. I saw that you had a weekend coming up in Swindon where you were going to teach hypnosis. I also saw that I just missed one in Croydon the weekend before, which is right down the road from me. So I was a bit gutted about that. But instead, I travelled to Swindon and I met you and we did a weekend workshop. It blew my mind completely. It just opened up new possibilities to me. I remember driving away from there on my hands-free, talking to my partner at the time, saying, "Oh my God, I've got magic powers." I couldn't believe what was going on. It was a completely new world that had opened up to me, but I wasn't using it for anything therapeutic or to help people at all, because that wasn't my interest. I was just curious. It was the same year I learned to juggle and I learned some magic tricks. It was just that sort of thing. Basically, I would just use it to impress people at the pub. A friend of mine was a very good responder and was happy for me to hypnotise her. We'd be in the pub, I'd stick her hand to the table, get her to forget her name, occasionally make her think the barmaid had stolen her boobs, things like that. Nothing I'm proud of, but...
I still do that.
This is it, when you're a young hypnotist and you've just discovered these magical powers. But one day she said to me, "Why don't you use this for something useful?" I said, "I believe I am." But then she said, "No, no, seriously, I'm getting married, as you know, and I don't want to wear false nails because they're uncomfortable." Yet she was a massive nail biter, a real chronic nail biter. She would bite her nails when in front of the TV of an evening. She would only notice she was biting them when she started to taste blood, or she just felt that pain when she'd gone a bit too far. I said to her, "Look, I've not been trained in anything therapeutic. I don't know how to do this. It wouldn't be ethical."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.